Hello friends, in this video I will be helping with acceptance testing. So let's start. So acceptance testing is a software testing where a software is tested for acceptability. Let me give you a good example. For example, you want to marry a girl and you want to know that whether your parents will allow or not. So what you will do at first, whether to know this, is you will go to your friends and you will ask them that I want to marry a girl and I want to know whether my parents will allow or not. So your friends will give you an unsure answer, right? Then you will consult with your colleagues, your mates, or even your close ones, and you may also go to a relative, but their answer will be just unsure, or you can say you can never be sure about that, right? So what is the best way to know is you can go to your parents, you can say that my friends want to get married to a girl like this and so, is it good or is it acceptable or not, right? Then you will be able to know the decision of your parents. So that is an example of acceptance testing, or you can say how acceptance testing works in software testing. Okay, so acceptance testing is testing the software in its original environment, or you can say towards the original user. Okay, so if any bugs, any defects or any errors are left, that can be cached or that can be rectified, so that when it will be deployed or when it will be released in the original environment, then it will not have any bugs, any defects. So that is why it is called as acceptance testing. We try to make the software accepted by the user only. So acceptance testing is useful. Why? There are three main reasons for that. First reason is they capture user requirement in a directly verifiable way. Why? So because we are directly trying to verify it by the user. So user will be the best person to tell that software is missing these much of requirement, or software should have this feature, or this is not right, this is all right, right? So that is a directly verifiable way. And second thing is they identify problem which unit or integration testing may have missed. Why? So because in unit testing we used to test each units, and in integration testing we used to test on modules, how modules work well with each other, right, in coordination. But if we see acceptance testing, it tests the functionality of the software, right? It does not sees any module, or it does not sees any units. It sees the whole software, right, as a single unit. So that is what the best part of acceptance testing is. Okay, and the third thing is they provide an overview on how done the system is. So with the help of acceptance testing, or you can say by consulting with the user, we are able to best know that whether a particular software is done or not, or whether a particular software is ready for deployment or release or not. Okay, so what are the various forms of acceptance testing? First is user acceptance testing. What we do is we go to the user. For example, in banking system or payments, there we can't risk, okay, there we can't take a third user or third person for the purpose of testing. So there what we do is we call the bank personals, or we call that particular industry personals to test the software, that whether it is feeding their requirements or not, right? So that is a kind of user acceptance testing where original user is taken in account for testing the software before its release. Second is business acceptance testing. Now in this we try to understand the business perspective or business idea before that particular software. For example, you are preparing a website, right? You are making a website that does system maintenance. So that will see that how it is loading data into database and how it is responding to that particular each of the user according to their complaints, right? So we test the business perspective or business functionalities of the software, and we test each of the business perspective, each business idea or each business perspective of that particular software by calling some businessman, okay, related to that particular business. Like for example, you want to test the database of a software, then you will call a personal from a database, right? Third is alpha testing. Alpha testing is testing of the software in controlled environment or internal environment. Let me give you a good example. Like Jio was about to release, right? I guess all of you know about Jio. So Jio is just like a mobile service provider, right? So before Jio's release, right, it was provided to its internal user for testing how Jio works, how Jio network works, or how well it is, how good the connection is, what are the bugs, what are the defects. But it was only provided to the internal organization of that Jio family or Jio user, right? Like whosoever Jio users were working in that company, the Jio SIM was provided to them before its release, so that they can tell that these functions are not there, or these functionalities or features can be added. So that is a kind of alpha testing, where you're testing the software in control environment or within the you can say with the help of the internal personal or internal people of the software developing feature. Next is beta testing. In beta testing, what we do is we say, okay, we are giving you the software, but we are not responsible how it will interact with your computer or with your device, right? So you have seen in Play Store, right, there is a beta option over there, right? So you can be a beta tester and you can download that software and you can report any bugs or any mishaps, right? But in that case, the software is not released, the software version is not released. So if your device is damaged or affected or infected or any other loopholes happens, then particular company won't be responsible for that. So that is a kind of beta testing, where software is not released, software is just given to the original users, and they are said that, okay, you can give us give us some feedback regarding that software, that what are the bugs, what are the errors, or what are the mishaps you are receiving, and according to that they work on that software, and until unless they are not satisfied fully, they don't release the software. Next is typical acceptance criteria. What are the typical acceptance criteria? First is functional correctness and completeness. So first thing what we test is the software functionally correct, or we can say for whatever reason we are preparing the software, or whatever the idea behind the software was, is the software serving that idea or not? Okay, and second is completeness, whether the particular software is complete, whether the particular software is functioning, whether the particular software is giving all the functionalities for what it was prepared for or not. Okay, next is performance. Now performance is very important, because nowadays hundreds of software are there, so performance is a criteria on which you can tell whether a particular software is good, bad, or okay, right? So performance is tested. Next is confidentiality. Now whatever data it is serving or whatever data is distributing, the confidentiality of the data is very, very important nowadays, because data of the user is very important nowadays. You can see big companies like Facebook and all are paying lots of money for protecting their user data. So confidentiality is kept in mind. And second is availability. Now that particular software should be available all the time, because user can access that particular software anytime, right? So availability is also checked. And next is usability. Now usability is how easy the software is, or you can say how easily particular software can be operated by the personnel or the users. So that is the example of usability. So now I guess the acceptance testing idea is clear to you. Still, let me give you a short overview of that if you are not still clear with the idea of acceptance testing. First of all, acceptance testing is nothing, just the testing of the software as a whole. Okay, as a customer provided wanted a software to be constructed and asked the software developer to develop a particular software. So what will they do is they test that particular the requirements of the users are accepted or not, or particular functionalities which are needed by the user are present in the software or not. So that is the acceptance testing. Okay, so acceptance testing, as I told you, is done in four ways. That is user acceptance testing, that is original user testing. Next is business acceptance testing, where we test the business idea behind that particular software. Then alpha testing, where we test the software in a internal control environment. Okay, so that that particular software doesn't cause any damage to the external user, or does not you can say create some loss to someone else, okay, externally. Next is beta testing, when software is okay, or you can say bit ready, then they release a they don't release the software, they just provide the software to the external user for reporting of any bugs, any left errors, or any other mishaps, so that the software can be fully rectified before the release. So after release, nothing wrong happens, still happens, because it is just a software and there are hundreds of you can say inputs or different kinds of things can happen, right? So this was all about acceptance testing. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching, and please do share your views in comments.